हेलो सर, ऑल गुड सर? थे
या गुड गुड गुड
ऑल आर गुड।
या
सो विल शेयर यू द स्क्रीन सर फॉर गेम्स विल स्टार्ट और पजल्स।
गेम्स
You can see the board, sir. You can see the board, sir?
Yeah.
So you are white. You can take your time, sir. You can eat and
D4.
D4, then opponent is playing D5.
C4.
C4, then opponent is capturing the pawn.
E3,
then opponent is defending that pawn with the bishop.
A4.
A4 is a side pawn.
B3.
D3, then opponent will capture your queen or bishop if you play D3.
Oh, horse to C3.
Knight to C3, okay. Now from here, he is defending that pawn again with the side pawn. So what you will do?
A4.
No, from here A4 we can't play, because from here if he's capturing, then if we are capturing with the queen or knight, it will be tempo loss for us.
I see.
Yeah, so A4 is a bad move.
Queen to e2.
Yeah, queen to e2, making the battery of queen and bishop. Then again, he is defending that pawn. A6. Actually, e2, you can play and you can directly take the advantage also if you don't want to play queen to e2.
He can come to f3 also.
But that will be in the corner. The queen, then where the pawn of f2 will go and where the knight will go on g1. So queen, it's not compulsory to play, but if you want to play that, e2 is a good square. If you want to play queen, e2 is a good square. But if you can want to take the advantage, you can take the advantage, free point also. You don't want to play queen.
फ्री पॉन तो नहीं मिलेगी।
या यू आर गेटिंग फ्री। इफ यू डोंट प्ले e2, यू कैन सी यू आर गेटिंग वन फ्री पॉन।
followers hoga because then he'll play this, then I will come back. Anyway, theek hai leta hu.
Yes, you are getting free pawn, so we can do tempo lords, then no problem. You are capturing that b5 pawn of the knight.
Yeah.
Yeah, so if now he is attacking your knight, then again you are getting advantage. It's not a tempo loss. And if he is pushing pawn also, then also it's not a tempo loss. Just you have to go back one more. But we got one point extra, so it's okay to go back. If he's playing bishop, we can punish.
I'm taking his pawn, c4.
Correct, perfect. We are getting another pawn. Now from here, if he's taking your knight.
Then I'll take my knight.
You will take his bishop. Or knight.
No, I'll take his bishop, na?
Yeah. So from here, he can just defend by playing the pawn. He can just play to c6. Only one square, yes.
चने का दाल था ये बाकी मैडम को दी. He is attacking my bishop. Huh?
Yeah, and also defending the check at the same time. With the pawn. And 1 point we up. And also you can see the pawn on c6 that is pinned with the bishop. If the bishop will stay in the same diagonal.
I'm pushing the bishop to a4.
Yeah, moving back the bishop to a4. Now from here, he'll continue the development. He'll play the knight to f6.
I'm playing my other knight.
Yeah.
F3.
So from here he is playing G6. Trying to castle on the king side.
I'm castling on the king side.
No, castling on the king side, he'll play the bishop in the G file and he'll try to defend the king also at the same time. Now he'll play defensive game. He has to expose the king. So how we can expose the king now? All the pieces are now developed. Whatever pieces are not in the open file, you have to bring in the open file.
I have to bring the queen out to d3.
D3, then it will be in the same file. And after d3, where the queen will go?
I see.
Yeah, so it should attack the king side, every piece.
So I'll have to come to b3.
Correct. Queen is going in the corner, no problem. But queen is attacking the king side in the same diagonal. Now he'll castle on the king side. Now from here you have to use all the concepts, double attack, pin, everything. and you have to exchange the pieces because you are 1 point up for checkmate. You have to exchange the pieces, whatever coming in between. Happy Navratri, sir. Yeah.
Same to you.
Yeah, thank you. You have to double attack all the pieces and you have to exchange the pieces that are coming in between.
Bringing the camel, which is on c1,
correct,
to d2,
then it will take 2-3 moves, but that bishop will be in the good attacking square, so we can push that bishop. We can invest the moves on that. So now from here he'll play the knight to d7, playing the defensive game. All the pieces he's bringing near the king. Sacrificing things to make the defensive position.
Bringing the camel to b4.
B4, the bishop, which dark square bishop. Yeah. Then from here, you are attacking the e7 pawn with the bishop. So you'll try to defend that, playing the queen on e8. He's adding defender, you have to add attackers.
Bringing my rook from f1 to d1.
Yeah, so d1, and now from here he'll also bring the rook from a8 to d8. You have to expose the king side.
For the horse, I'm bringing it to e5.
Okay. So from here, he can capture your knight.
Exchange the knight.
And you are 1 point up, so you can exchange.
No advantage.
Yeah, that knight, if you don't want to exchange, but you have to exchange other pieces. Because to expose the king, you have to get rid of all the pieces coming up.
I'm taking his pawn on c6.
Correct, that free piece we are getting, that we can take first. Now from here, he'll play e6. Then what we can do from here, he's doing blunder. All the concepts here.
Capture is this thing.
Correct, the rook is more important. So from here, he'll play just side pawn because all the pieces are stuck. If you can see, all the black pieces are stuck. He'll play h5. Now he'll expose the king side. Which piece you think it's not important, you can exchange them. and pawn promotion is also important.
Pushing my pawn
d5. Okay, yes. So from here, he'll also attack that pawn, and he'll play e6 because that pawn is very dangerous. That pawn comes more near. So e6, he's playing, doing the same mistake. So from here, what we can do? There's no other option. If you play then d6. Will be threat pawn.
Either exchange ho jayega.
Yes, in the end game and middle game you have to exchange. Whatever pieces are not required, or you are 1-2 points up, you have to exchange.
पहले तो उसका पॉन ले लेते हैं ना e5 6.
करेक्ट. ओके दैट. बट फर्स्ट यू आर गेटिंग एडवांटेज. लाइक ही इज डूइंग ब्लंडर. ही इज प्लेइंग e6. सो 2 पॉइंट्स.
सो टेक इज रुक.
करेक्ट. वी आर गेटिंग एडवांटेज. दिस इज नॉट एक्सचेंज, दिस इज एडवांटेज. सो वी विल कैप्चर योर बिशप विद द बिशप. सो 2 पॉइंट्स वी गॉट. फर्स्ट 2 पॉइंट्स वी वर हैविंग. 4 पॉइंट्स वी आर. Now you can expose his king.
Now I'm capturing e6.
Okay, perfect. And he is capturing your pawn with the pawn. Now his king is exposed. Just here to exchange the pieces and you need to checkmate. Keep exchanging more and more pieces. Now you can see you that knight on d7 that is pinned, so you can easily take advantage with the help of the knight. That d7 knight is pinned. Let to see how it's pinned. So suppose that knight is not there only.
I move my knight from f3 to d4.
D4, yes, d4, then rook open file will be stopped. If you can see, then rook, you will not get open file. Yeah, you have to move the knight only, but where you will move the knight and what is the best square or knight? And more near to the king.
e5.
Correct. First, you are moving that knight to e5. That knight was capturing your knight. Now that knight can't capture your knight because that knight is pinned. Mm-hmm. If he'll capture your knight, you can capture his queen. So he can do nothing from here. He can just try to discover attack your knight by playing the bishop on g7. Indirectly attacking your knight. So three attackers, three defenders. The pawn on e6, that is pinned. The knight on d7, that is pinned. All the pieces around the king need to exchange. Need to check in.
F4, the pawn.
On f4, yes. Now from here he'll try to discover attack the knight. So he'll play the knight to g4. He can play to d5 also, but that he'll be one pawn down and his king will be more exposed. He's playing to g4.
And take his knight on d7.
Perfect. So there you can see only two defenders are there. The third defender went away. So that knight, how you will take? With which piece? Bishop, knight or rook?
With knight.
Yes, with the knight. Now from here you can take your knight with the rook. Because afterwards its king, queen is also under attack. Then he can run away. The queen can run away after this. So with which piece you will take?
With rook.
Perfect. With the rook, so afterwards if the queen is not moving, we can get the discover attack also. That's why with the rook. And the major piece is coming more near the king. So the queen has to move. Queen will go to f8. If he's good player, he'll move the queen. Play the queen to f8. Now he'll go for draw because he knows the 9 points he's down.
I'm capturing his pawn on e6.
With the queen. Yes. Oh.
Queen.
Now you just go in the corner to h8. Now you have to check me. Find the check.
Capturing his pawn.
With G6. Yeah. Okay. From here, he'll play the knight to E5 using the fork concept.
Sorry.
No, it's okay. You have the queen, so you can do anything.
No, I don't want to lose that.
You have checkmate into
moves.
So if you have queen and it's very near to the king, you don't have to worry. Any concept he will lose, use, and he'll lose.
I'm taking
his
h5 pawn.
And there is a check, only one square the king has. The king can go only on g8. Now you have to find the checkmate. And if he is playing to e5, the four concept he is using, just you can simply capture the knight with the pawn.
First I am capturing the knight.
First you are capturing the knight. Now from here he'll capture your pawn with the bishop.
Moving my camel to d5.
Correct. Now from here he can just do one thing. He can just bring the queen in between to f7. So now find the checkmate. Maximum 2 moves you have to take for checkmate.
Taking his queen with my camel.
The bishop, you are taking the queen. Then from here, he can run to f8. Now find the checkmate.
Otherwise, I'll take it. Later.
Yes. If that, this also you can do, it will take a bit long. Otherwise, directly also you can checkmate from here. So major piece, with the major piece.
Checkmate.
So with which piece you will take
checkmate.
The queen?
No, with the queen.
With the queen, you are taking the queen. Now from here, he can go to h8. So after this, there is a checkmate. Two checkmates here to find for me. Two checkmates.
So queen will go to h7.
Perfect. That is the first checkmate, queen in helper mate. And the second back rank mate.
Queen will go to f8.
Yeah, and one more. If you can see, one more is there.
Queen can come to h5.
h5, then king can go to g8. Yeah, king can't go because the bishop is there. Yeah, that is one. And another one more checkmate is there. Three checkmates. Fourth one. If not with the queen, then.
With the rook.
Yes, that is also checkmate. Rook you can bring to 8-9. So these are four different checkmates you can do. So this is the opening when he is playing the bishop and defending the pawn with the bishop. Now you want to continue, sir, with one more with white or black?
Okay, one more white pudding. Chalo.
Okay. Stonewall. You saw that anniversary video, sir? Your wishes and everything.
Very nice. Yeah.
10 to 12 minutes.
Just you sent me, but you didn't send me.
No, I sent you. I sent you on that day also and before that day also. First, I sent you only. I'll send you again.
Anniversary, ka?
Yeah, anniversary. 10 to 12 minutes. In that, your wishes were there. You sent me that video. I collaborated, merged that video. 10-12 minutes video. Not of live session.
One more.
10 minutes video. Should I show you here on the screen?
Ha, sure.
Yes. Yeah, YouTube you can see. YouTube is opening. Yeah, now you can see, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. In this video, celebration video. It's a bit long, 10 minutes video.
Hashtag MPI. Hashtag. Cheers to you all out there.
आगे कर सकते
हैं। यस यस। सो फ्रॉम विशेस विल स्टार्ट।
हैशटैग।
When I first joined the class, I didn't know a single algorithm of two. But in a month, I reached till F2L method. This is only because of professor. Thank you, Rohan sir, for teaching me very well. And happy first anniversary to Mumbai Training Institute.
से आते हैं हमें तड़पाते हैं वो चिट्ठी आती है तो पूछे जाते
नाउ योर वीडियो
रोहन सर टॉट मी दिस थैंक यू सर टू टीच मी सो वेल
इन Hi, it's a pleasure to know Rohan Makija, who has been, playing chess with me and has made me learn a lot about chess. It's been a year since Mumbai Institute started, and I congratulate Rohan for a success for his first anniversary. And I love the game, and I love playing with Rohan. Thank you.
Thank you, Mumbai Training Institute and Rohan for the training. What took me many years
to teach
me just two sessions. One.
Thank you.
All the best.
So all the wishes.
Online.
My sister and auntie.
And I hope you inspire a lot of other people. And
your sister and auntie.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
And anyway,
मैं फोन से रहे तेरी आन सदा चले जान मेरी ये रहे ना रहे
मेरी जमीन है लोग मेरी मेरी नस नस में तेरा इश्क बहे फीका ना पड़े कभी रंग तेरा जिस मुंह से निकल के खून कहे
Yes, there are many YouTubers that shout out.
Yeah. So this is the anniversary.
Nice.
Sorry, wasted your time.
We'll start.
Yeah.
No. Very nice.
Okay.
I didn't see the whole thing, so.
It's of 12 minutes.
Very
now,
nice.
So, yeah. I'll send you the link.
Yeah.
I'll send you the link again. Yeah. So you are
D5.
White, D4. And he's playing D5. Stone.
C4.
C4, then if he is now not capturing the pawn, instead he is playing the knight, side knight, C6, another knight, attacking the pawn on D4.
C3.
Knight to C3, from here he is playing E6.
I am playing e6.
Yeah, e3 you are playing.
Yeah.
If you have chance, you can take the bishop also out in the beginning, because he is not attacking and he is letting you play the bishop. So you can play the bishop also in the beginning.
f4 bishop.
Yeah, bishop to f4, then from here he is playing knight to f6.
Now I'm playing e3.
Yeah, now you can play e3, and from here he'll play g6.
Queen to e2.
Queen to e2. So from here he'll cast. He'll try to cast it on the king side. So first he'll play g7. The bishop to g7.
I'm castling.
You're castling on the queen side now, he'll castle on the king side. So now you have a good chance to attack. The opposite side, if we are castling, we have more chances to attack. If the same side we are castling, so we have to play the defensive game in the beginning.
Knight to f3.
Knight to f3. So from here, he'll play the queen to d7. Trying to make the battery in the center fight. To control the center now, all the four pieces, e4, e5, d4, d5, those four pieces you have to control.
g3, pawn.
g3 you are playing, from here he will continue b6.
Bishop to f3.
Bishop to
f3.
h3, yes. Now from here he will continue the bishop to a6. Indirectly attacking your queen. Discover attack.
Keep pushing the pawn.
Yeah, pawn promotions you can.
Pawn to g4.
Pawn to g4 on the side pawn you are pushing and trying to attack the king side. You will bring the rook from a8 to d8, making the battery of queen and rook.
Pushing the pawn further.
Which g4 pawn you will push? g5 you are playing. Now from here, he'll play the knight in the corner. You don't have any other option. You can't go back also. So he'll play the knight to h5. Now the pieces are equal, but the position is good.
bringing the rook, which is on h1 to yes. g1.
To g1 in the open file. Now from here, he'll push f6. Trying to get open file, but he is exposing his king side. We can expose this king side and exchange all the pieces near the king.
Push the pawn e4.
e4 if you can play, so he'll capture your e4 pawn with the pawn and you get the open file and queen and
open
rook
file.
Battle.
Rook, queen and rook battle.
So how we can exchange the pieces?
Take
how we can get the advantage.
That will not be advantage.
Expose his king side, so you have to first target those three pawns on f, g, and h5, and knight and bishop, and the rook. Then afterwards, the queen side pieces.
Will you do then a take his pawn on f6?
Yes, that we can do first. Now from here, he'll capture with the rook to get the open file. So afterwards, what we can do? Now we have the best move. Thank you.
I can bring my camel.
Yeah.
To
G4.
G5. G5, yeah.
Yes. So if you bring G5, then you are using the pin concept and double attack concept. Both the rooks you are attacking at the same time. So any one he can save. So better he'll try to capture the knight with the rook. Now from here, what we can do?
Capturing his rook.
Yeah, with the queen.
My queen.
Yes, now he'll play the another rook to f8. And will attack the queen. Still we are having advantage.
He's attacking my queen.
Yeah, he's attacking the queen and saving the rook also at the same time. Now, if you don't want to move the queen from that open file, you can bring any piece in between or you can capture something.
So let's move the queen.
Yeah, queen to where you can move the queen.
G4.
Perfect. And if you don't want to move the queen, then you can bring the bishop in between. That you can do. And if you want to move the queen, G4 is the best play. Now from here, he'll play the queen on F7. And making the battery of queen and rook. From here, how we can break his defense and how we can expose his king. Next move, he wants to capture the F2 pawn, if you can see. That's why he's making the battle. So let him capture. So how we can take advantage of that. Let him capture. That will be sacrifice, a good sacrifice, if you give the F2 pawn. So how it will be the sacrifice and what advantage you will get, you have to calculate.
I can move that F2 pawn to F3.
F3 we can move, still he'll take that f3 pawn with the queen because he is getting one pawn extra. But how we can
then I'll take his queen.
Then he'll take your queen with the rook.
Ah.
That's why he's making the battle. Let him take f2 pawn, no problem. Afterwards we can take advantage. But what we can do now, if he'll take f2. If you don't have
anything... Then I'll take his e6 pawn.
Yeah, e6, that we want to target. Yes, perfect. That we want. Yeah. That e6 pawn we want. So you can waste one move. If you don't have anything to play, and if you want opponent to play first, you can waste move. You can play something that is not
so I'm going to
worth. Yeah.
I'll play...
You can save your king. You
my
can
rook to f1. Huh?
Yeah. So f1, if you will play first, then the queen will not capture that f2 pawn. Yes, let him capture. Let him capture. Try to trap the opponent.
I'll play the e4.
Yeah, e4, then he'll capture your e4 pawn first. Because he is getting that pawn also. Yes.
Well, I'll capture.
With the knight?
With my horse.
With the knight, if you will capture, then he'll not capture the pawn on f2. Because the knight is defending
him.
Not
have.
Yes. Like this, you have to calculate.
So I'll play my rook to h1.
Okay, that we can do h1. Now he is capturing your f2 pawn. Now you can take the advantage.
Now I'll capture e6.
e6, perfect. Now he can just go in the corner. He'll go in the corner in the h6. Now we have to expose your skill. Now the best move you are having. The basic rule, don't let the opponent piece stand near the king. And first you are trying this, so the f2 pawn was there. You are trying to defend.
To F1 now, I'll bring the rook.
Correct. Which rook, any rook you can bring.
H1 to F1.
Yeah. Now the queen has to go away from that file. And the queen has to leave that file. So the queen has only one square. The queen can go back to F7. But still, you can capture his queen. And you are getting the queen, if you can see. The queen is trapped. You are trapping the queen. From here, the queen is trapped. Queen can't go anywhere.
I'm taking his queen.
Yeah, with the
rook.
With the rook you are taking, his rook will take your rook. Now again, you are getting advantage.
Now I'm taking his rook.
Perfect. Now from here, he'll try to defend, but it's not possible to defend this position. So he'll bring the knight to f6. Anyways, he is losing. Now, checkmate in 4 moves.
So, I am bringing the king. Sorry.
Yeah.
Queen to e8.
e8 directly, if you will bring, he will defend the check with the knight. So his king will be safe. From here you want to continue, you can continue. You have the pieces, so you can double attack the knight.
So I'll bring my rook to f1.
Rook to f1. From here he'll play...
No, so I will not... I'm not moving my queen now.
Okay, you're not moving
first I'm bringing the rook to f1, yeah.
Okay. And now from here he'll go to... G indirectly. Exposes
bringing my camel,
yeah,
to e6.
e6, perfect. Now from here he'll again defend that knight. It's not possible, but he'll try. At least he'll bring the knight to e7 from c6.
Panch baat ke liye,
ha,
I'm capturing his knight.
On which knight?
E7.
Yes. With the queen or bishop?
Bishop.
Yes, perfect. Now he can't capture the bishop. If he's capturing, then also it's checkmate. If he's not capturing, then also it's checkmate. So from here, what you will do if he's capturing on E7? If he's not capturing, then directly checkmate. If he's capturing, then it will take two moves. In two moves, you have to checkmate. Anything he do, in two moves, it's checkmate.
Queen to e8.
Perfect. Now from here, he can just bring the knight in between or bishop in between. Anything, any piece he's bringing in between, it's a checkmate. Knight is playing to g8.
Yeah, now I'll remove the knight.
Yeah, and you will capture with?
Queen.
Queen. Queen in helper mate. Standard checkmate. Back rank mate. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like this, you have to bring all the pieces near and you have to checkmate in the back rank. I'll send you the link, sir, again on WhatsApp of all the videos, anniversary and everything. So tomorrow we can do, sir, anytime if you are available. Yeah. Okay, sir. Yeah. Tomorrow we can do if you are available.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes. Happy Navratri, sir. Yeah. Bye.
Okay. Bye. Bye. Bye.